إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله لا نبي بعده اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين عما بعد فيا عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله تعالى وطاعته لعلكم تفلحون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما قال الله تعالى في كتابه الكريم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم اتل ما أوحي إليك من الكتاب وأقم الصلاة وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون Sadaqallahu al-Azim. Alhamdulillah wa syukurillah. All praises and thanks to Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the blessings that we have, including the blessing that we have today. So alhamdulillah, today is Friday, which is the best day of the week in Islam. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, whoever come to the Friday prayers, listen to the khutbah attentively, then Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive his sin until the next Friday. May Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the one whom he forgive. Amin. Amin ya rabbal alamin. Brother and sister rahimakumullah, this is winter time, so we don't have a lot of time for this khutbah because we have to finish this Friday prayer and khutbah before the Asr prayer. So I just want to give you, all of us over here, one reminder. And also, this is a good news for us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-Ankabut, this is Surah number 29, ayat 45. Utlu ma uhiya ilaika minal kitabi wa aqimis sholah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that, read, explain the Quran to the one that do not know or do not understand the Quran, and establish the prayers, the five daily prayers. Inna salata tanha 'anil fahsya'i wal munkar. And this is the promise from Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. If we perform, if we establish these five daily prayers, the obligatory prayers, with khushu, devotion, concentration, then Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect us from making misconduct, making big sin, making inappropriate things, wrongdoings in our life. But remember, the five daily prayer that we have to perform has to be perfect, in full of devotion and concentration with khushu. Now the question is, are we 100% sure that our five delivery is we perform in the perfect time? in perfect condition in the khusu, full of devotion and concentration? And most of the time the answer is no. Most of the time is the answer. When we pray, when we say Allahu Akbar, sometimes at that time we remember where we lost our key, right? Sometimes we remember, wow, I lost my key over here. Or sometimes when we say Allahu Akbar, what happened? We remember that someone owed us something, money, and then during the prayer we're planning that how we're gonna tell that he actually owed me money, how I can get that money. Sometimes like that, right? And we pray together in Friday prayer. How many times we hear the phone ringing? How many times? And what happened with us? We get upset, we get angry, we lost our concentration. And what happened with our prayer? It's not that perfect. Should we repeat our prayers? That's the question. Should we repeat it? The good news is no. Because if we try to repeat our prayer, the imperfect prayers like that, we will never finish our prayers. We will never finish our prayer because there is always some defect in our prayer. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. He give us the blessing. He give us the information. He give us the help. And this help is coming from what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. Abu Hurairah radhiyallahu anhu qala Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, inna awwala ma yuhasabu bil 'abdi yawm al-qiyamah min amalihi salatuhu. The first amal, the first action that will be judged from my servant in the day of judgment is his 5 daily prayers, the 5 obligatory prayers. Fa'in saluhat, if this 5 daily prayer is good, perfect, faqad aflaha wa anjaha, then he will be successful. He will be prosper in the hereafter. He will enter the paradise. Fa'in fasadat, however, if this prayer is not good, it means fasadat over here, he actually did not perform the prayer, or he missed so many obligatory prayers. Then what happened? Faqad khaba wa khasira. Then he will be fail. He will fail, and he will be the loser in the hereafter. So this is for the one that do not really perform the or establish the 5 daily prayers. And unfortunately, there are many people that actually only pray one time a year. Sometimes they only come for Idul Fitr or Idul Adha. And this is not even the obligatory prayers. They did not perform the daily prayer. And this is what we call the fasadat, the one that have bad action on their daily prayer. How about most of us? Yes, we perform our prayer, right? We follow the rule, we follow the arkan. However, most of the time it's not perfect, as I mentioned before. Sometimes it's not full concentration. Then what happened? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Fa in taqasa min faridatihi shay'un," if there is a defect in his 5 daily prayers, in his fardu prayers, there are some defects on it, then qala Rabbu 'azza wa jalla, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell the angels, will tell the angel, "Unzuru, look for what? Hal li'abdi min tatawwu'in," look for the additional prayers that my abdu, my servant make, the sunnah prayers, the nawafil prayers. Do we perform it? And if we do, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, fayukammala biha man taqasa min faridah, then use these additional prayers, the nawafil prayers, to make a perfection of his defective 5 daily prayer. So this is the invitation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do our additional prayer, nawafil prayer, because it's not only increase our reward, but also it is used for what? For perfection of our daily prayer, which is actually most of them do not have that perfection during our daily prayers. Then Allah Subhanahu wa Taala say, Prophet Muhammad SAW say in this hadith, ثُمَّ يَكُونُ سَائِرُ عَمَلِهِ عَلَى ذَلِكَ. Then the next action will be also performed at the same like the prayer is judged. So maybe the next action is what? Zakah. So if there is no imperfection in our zakah, maybe it's a little bit less, or maybe we don't really fully, you know, pay our zakah as calculation, then Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala tell the angel to look for the charity. The charity is nawafil for the zakah. And then how about the Ramadan? Fasting sometimes is not perfect. Then Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala will tell the angel, look for the additional fasting. For Hajj, you can imagine Hajj. Many people think that the first Hajj is not that perfect. They want to do it again, do it again. Believe me, it will never finish if you try to repeat the Hajj many times. But Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala is merciful. He said that, look for the additional Hajj. What is that? The additional action of Hajj, Umrah. He will look for the Umrah to make perfection of the Hajj. And just imagine in some country like Indonesia, if you register Hajj today, you will go for Hajj 20 years later. Because so many people want to go for Hajj. You register today, you have to wait 20 years to go for Hajj in Indonesia. Because they only take 200,000 from Indonesia, and there are millions of Indonesians that want to go for Hajj at the same time. So most of the time they're going to wait 15-20 years, you can imagine that. So if we think that we have to repeat something that is not perfect, then it will not give you a perfect. And some people will not get the time for going for Hajj. So there are so many additional nawafil prayers. And the scholar mentioned that there are two types of additional prayer, which is what we call the mu'akkad. It's really highly recommended. And ghairu mu'akkad, which is that is not that highly recommended. And I believe I don't have time to explain it, but inshallah, tomorrow morning after the Fajr time, I will try to discuss this in this masjid, inshallah, after Fajr time, if you come to Fajr tomorrow morning, inshallah. May Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala give us the understanding for this khutbah, and may Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala help us, make us easy to perform additional nawafil ibadah, nawafil prayers. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'ani al-Karim wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum bima fihi min al-ayati wa dhikril hakim wa taqabbalu wa minni wa minkum tilawatahu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات لأولي الألباب أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله لا نبي بعده اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد قال الله تعالى إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم fil alamina innaka hamidum majid. Allahumma ighfir lil muslimina wal muslimat wal mu'minina wal mu'minat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat wa ya qadiyal hajat. Rabbana la tuzigh qulubana ba'da idh hadaytana wa hab lana min ladunka rahmah innaka antal wahhab. Rabbana hab lana min azwajina wa dhurriyyatina qurrata a'yun waj'alna lil muttaqina imama. Rabbi ja'alna muqima salawatina wa min turiyatina. Rabbana wa taqabbal du'a. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka antas samiul alim wa tub 'alaina innaka antat tawwabur rahim. Rabbana atina min ladunka rahmatan wa hayyi lana min amrina rasyada. Rabbana atina fid dunya hasanah wa fil akhirati hasanah wa qina 'adzabanna wa qina 'adzabanna. Ibadallah. Inna Allah ya'muru bil 'adli wal ihsan wa ita'i dzil qurba wa yanha 'anil fahsya'i wal munkari wal baghyi ya'idukum la'allakum tadhakkarun wa dzkurullaha 'adzim wa la dzikrullahi akbar aqimish shalah.